These three are called null aware operators. First, let's take a look at this operator over here. Now, when you declare a variable before it, if it has a question mark, it means that the value of this variable could be potentially null. But in our case, we have assigned a value, so it's not null. Now, if it's not null, if we want to access the properties of this variable, we can access it using question dot. Like, for example, this is a string, so we can access the length of this variable. If we run it, here we'll see 7. Now, because str string is not null, so we can access the value. Now, in the second example over here, we see str, the value is null. If we run it, we'll see here it is null as well. And in this third example, we see that because this value could be potentially null and compiler knows that on the right hand side, we don't have any value for this variable. So when we do str.length, we can't compile it. We get error. So you won't be able to run it. We'll see it crashes over here. Now let's take a look at this second null aware operator. For this variable over here, we are saying the value could be potentially null, but we yet assign a value to it. Now in this case, if we go and run it, we'll see it prints Flutter awesome. Why it does that? Because first it tries to check for this variable if there is any value or not. If there is a value, then use that value. In our case, we are using this value and we print it. If there is no value, then we'll print this one. Now we run it, we'll see the value is printed, value is null. That's because on the right hand side, we don't have any value. So if there is a value on the right hand side, over here it prints the right hand side value. If there is no value, it would print the value over here, the one you mentioned in this expression. Now we'll look at the third null aware operator. Actually, this operator is extension of this operator. Well, what it means that if this variable is null, then assign this value. So in our case, we didn't assign any value to it. So over here, first it tries to evaluate the value and it finds this value is null, then assign it 1, 2, 3. If we run it, we'll see 1, 2, 3. Now another example is this one. Over here, I have assigned the value 1, 1, 1. So in this case, it will ignore this value over here because when it evaluates the value over here, it finds that there is a value. So it would print over here 1, 1, 1.